In this tutorial, we are going to create a user login in PHP. So first thing first, I have to create a new file called index.php. And this is going to be our entry point of our application. So instead of echo hello world, I'm going to create HTML page. With head title user login and body, and inside body I'm going to create a form, PHP form, sorry, HTML form with an action. Let's call our action login PHP. So we are going to have a separate file for form processing method post. And inside we will have three input elements. First one is username with a type text. So here we are going to have a username, and name of this input also username. Second one is a password. Type of this field is password. So data which we're going to put into this field will be obscured. And name of this field is password. These two names are going to be used in when we will submit a post request, and inside dollar underscore post PHP variable, we can get access to our submit data by using these two field names. And last one is going to be input type submit. This is going to be our button, which we will call login. All right, so we have our login form. Let's at h1 tag so it will look nicer. And let's go ahead and create a login.php file, and this file is going to be responsible for form processing. I'm going to assign everything which is inside global variable called dollar underscore post into my local variable called data. And with this data going forward, I'm going to work and validate what have been submitted. So we have data here. Let's print it and see. Yes, so we have two fields, username and password, and we are currently on login.php page, and we've successfully passed this data. The next step would be to actually validate whether or not we have data submitted. If we have empty form submitted, we are going to say or show a message that username and password are required. So I'm going to use empty function for the simplicity, and I will check if one of these two fields, username and password, is empty. I will call dive function and will provide a message: username and password are incorrect, or password are required. So let's try to submit. Yeah, And we have a message on login.php script that username or password are required. However, if I have this data, I am going to assign it. It's not a required step. However, it's a good practice to assign data which you are going to work with to a variable.